It is officially 9:17 p.m. I was perusing through one of my notebooks because it was a bit messy, you see. I was looking through what are these pieces of paper in the notebook, and I found this thing. You probably couldn't see it. These are questions from one of my talks. I think this was from UiTM Tapa. So basically, people invite me over to their place, university, organization, whatever, to give a talk. And then usually after the talk, there's a Q&A session. And in this particular Q&A session, we didn't have enough time to go through all the questions. So I think I decided to take home a few of these questions. And I think I promised to answer these questions maybe on my Facebook or something like that. But obviously, I did not do that. So I'm going to take this opportunity to fulfill the promise that I think I made in this video. All the questions are in Malay, so I'll try to translate it as best as I can. Macam mana nak ikhlaskan hati untuk lupakan? So basically, this question asks, how do we forget past failures and accept our current self? Okay, the easiest way to do that is to accept the fact that there's nothing you can do about the past. If you dwell on your past mistakes, you will never ever ever move on. You can't take back the thing that you do a second ago. Forget like a year ago, a second ago, it's lost. It's gone forever. So what you can control is what you do now. What you do now will define who you are today and tomorrow. Forget about yesterday. It's gone, it's past. Learn from the mistakes. Improve yourself today so that you become a better person tomorrow. Second question, bagaimana ingin menghadapi permintaan ibu bapa? The students are asking, how do we deal with parents who want the students, i.e. their children, to pursue a field that they, the children, don't want to pursue. With you and your parents, you should have a comfortable enough relationship such that you can discuss personal things. You can express your opinions, you can express your feelings, and there will be this mature conversation between two of you where you listen to their point of view and they listen to your point of view. The problem with these kind of questions is that it's always one-sided. It's always the students who are asking. I hope and I wish that in one of these programs, we can have like the youth and their parents together so that we can deal with it right there and then. But for now, what I can say is that the youth need to build bridges between them and their parents. Next question. Assalamualaikum. Waalaikumsalam. Saya ingin bertanya bagaimana kita perlu mengamalkan ilmu yang... Questioner is asking, how do we apply what we learn in university, the secular knowledge that we learn, how do we apply it as a Muslim? This is basically the issue of deen versus dunya. Do we choose deen or do we choose dunya? With this issue, I found an amazing answer by Numan Ali Khan. I'll link to that answer in the video description down below. Please watch the video. It's amazing. Next question. Whoa, see how long the question is? See? Baru tahu minat ke arah apa? Okay. Bila nak habis diploma, masalah nak bagi tahu parent pula. Again, not uncommon. It's a very common problem where students, they pursue something in university not because they want to, but because they follow their friends. Or they think that that particular course or degree is easy peasy. These students usually they don't know what they want in life, but they feel pressured to go to university anyway, which is fine, it's okay, but I think that these kind of students need a little bit of freedom to explore. If this particular person found what they like while studying in university, even if that something that they found is unrelated to what they are currently pursuing, they need to have that freedom to be able to make a choice whether to stick to what they are currently pursuing or change their majors. I'm not saying that they should change their majors, I'm just saying that they should be able to make that choice freely and comfortably, because this person is saying that they are afraid of telling their parents about it. Now again, with parents, you should be able to tell your parents almost anything, especially when it comes to like this kind of thing. This, by the way, is not that big of a deal. If you can't talk about this thing with your parents, then there are so many other more important things that you can't talk about with your parents. And that's a big, big, big loss on your part and on your parents' part. So you should be able to have that comfortable relationship such that this particular discussion is no big deal. Now, should you change your major or should you not? That's your choice. That's your choice. Next question. Selama beberapa tahun hidup asyik cari sijil dunia, macam mana nak ubah cara hidup bagi mencari sijil akhirat pula? The same question about deen and dunia. See, it's a very common thing. I'll give you the link to the Noman Ali Khan's answer. Amazing. Again, you should watch it. Last question. Bagaimana cara mengatasi saat diri sudah berputus asa? Okay, so this particular person has come to a point in his or her study life that they feel like they don't want to study anymore. They feel like giving up. When you want to give up on something, it's probably, I'm not saying this as a general rule, but it's probably, in my best estimate, it's probably because of your why is not strong enough. If you have passion for something, if you really have a big, big, huge goal in life, then any challenges you face will not bring you down. You will pursue something to the end. You will power through because you have a big why as a motivator. Ayo, that's it. Done.